My next guest today is Dave Trail from Arch Systems. Nice to see you, Dave.
Hey, Trevor. How are you? Good to see you again.
Yeah. You're a long way from home.
I am. It was a little bit of a long haul, but the show is important enough for us to come out and spend time in the industry. And we brought a little crew with us this time, so some of the newer people with our company. And there's nothing quite like actually seeing the equipment and seeing the industry. And there's just so much that you pick up at these trade shows that you can't really get by looking online.
Absolutely. Okay. So Arch Systems. I mean, you really have made your mark as the provider of heavy data services for Flex. Flex obviously has a number of facilities around the world.
Sure.
And you're pulling data from all of these facilities, crunching it and putting out meaningful results at the end of it. Tell us a little bit about that.
Sure. Yeah.
Story.
Flex was really one of our very first customers that we started doing business with. And it's been great for both organizations because we were able to work very closely with them, and they've also had a little voice in how we've developed our product over the years and things like that. And it's been enormously successful. We're currently installed at all of their SMT manufacturing facilities worldwide.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little more than 40 facilities, and we have about 5,000 SMT machines connected into our system.
Wow.
Where we're collecting data. It's well over a trillion data points per month being digested within our system. So, yeah, it's a massive amount of data that's being crunched and analytics derived upon that and all these unique insights that you wouldn't necessarily be able to get without, this volume of data that we're working with.
So that's a huge amount of data, but, I mean, it's ongoing and it's building up into this mass of knowledge.
Sure.
That is helping, it's going back down into the manufacturing process. Have you seen some real results in terms of productivity and reliability?
Oh, sure. Yeah. We're, some of the, easier things that we're able to calculate is, utilization, really one of the more impactful analytical insights that we're able to get. And, that on a big corporation like that, we're talking, tens of millions of dollars a year in annual savings. And, then there's also things like attrition. And then once we start doing some quality correlations and, With that large amount of data, you're really able to provide huge ROI and massive savings for these companies that need to these days to stay competitive.
Yeah, machine downtime has obviously been a big thing that's going to come out of this factory of the future type of thing. But I mean, obviously all the Flex facilities benefit from that, but from their own data. But that's not something that you share with anybody else. So what happens to the little guys? We need a system that's going to pull data from everybody.
Sure.
And make it available to everybody who's subscribed to it.
Yeah, certainly. And, as we mentioned before, that's something the industry has been talking about for a little while. Everybody wants to be the Google of manufacturing, if you will. And if anybody's poised for that, I would say Arch is. Whether I work at Arch or not, there's really nobody in the industry that's working with as much data and is able to process that amount of data in the timeliness that we're able to do that. So I think we're a little ways away from, this Google of manufacturing type of thing, but certainly that's something on everybody's minds, and, there'll be certain companies that get closer than others, but one of the key things that we need to look at that is everybody's still very secretive over their data, so we need to figure out a way to anonymize it. But certainly, it would be great in a future world where you could upload a circuit board design and say, what would happen in this type of process and be able to debug before you actually run it. So certainly that's something that we're looking forward to.
I mean, you're talking about taking some baby steps, though, towards that goal producing some modules. Can you tell us a little bit about these modules that you're...
Absolutely. Obviously we just talked about a very huge concept of data. It's a very broad subject, and it's big. To many companies, it's almost too big to really to bite off a chunk of that.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody wants this type of thing, but a lot of people don't necessarily know where to start. And, you end up with, stagnation on decision-making because, everybody wants to do these types of things, but where do I begin?
Right.
So as we started looking at our customer bases, we were looking at the people that use our software, and we noticed that there was you know, almost a bucketization, if you will, you know, where there's certain people in the quality department that are using our tool for, you know, unique analytics applied strictly to, you know, quality correlation and, you know, upstream detection and things like that. And then we also are doing quite a bit, you know, as you know, with the pick and place companies and, you know, looking at attrition and time loss waiting for parts. And we noticed that there was specific parts of our product that are well-tuned towards individual sections of most manufacturing organizations.
Right.
So rather than trying, well, in addition to selling an enterprise solution, which is what we'll always be and we'll always do, where we're talking with senior management and trying to sell the process down into the manufacturing floor, we've modularized or you know, parts of our product where we're able to sell little pieces of that that address a certain need on the factory floor level. Mm-hmm. That way people are able to get value out of it right away. Mm-hmm. And they're able to get ownership and provide, you know, benefits that directly affect them in addition to what they're doing for the broader benefit of the company.
Right. So let's drill down a little bit into these modular areas. You're talking about, for example, a module that will look at the inspection process.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And then a separate one that will look at the placement process.
Yeah.
Is that how you're planning to roll it out?
It's interesting that you bring that up because, you know, there's segmentation, but, you know, we're able to break off a chunk, if you will, that looks just at some of the test analytics, and then there's some modules and reports and analytical evaluations that are done specifically for the placement. But even on top of that, you know, you get more benefit once you start adding those two modules together, because then now you're doing quality correlation to your pick and place machines. Mm-hmm. So it's really building blocks that allow a company to use more and more of the product and grow with the product, you know, in addition to getting the benefits of the broader industry 4.0 thing that everybody's chasing.
Right. Yeah, the only thing I can see with that though, Dave, is that obviously there's a bit of a competition going on at the moment between the inspection people who want to control the line, as it were, and the pick and place vendors who also have line management software.
Sure.
And nobody knows at this point who's going to win that battle. You know, you've already got two big competitors in the ring.
Well, that's one way to look at it. And actually, when we walked into the trade show, when it began, is, you know, we were looking at, you know, there's a school of thought that the material handling people, because they touch every board, you know, they should be the brain of the factory. And then the AOI guys, because the amount of data that they're getting, you know, should be, you know, the overlord, if you will. Arch really doesn't have a position that any one of those are competitors. I don't want to get that impression out there whatsoever, because we do want all of these equipment manufacturers to come out with the best software that applies to what their specialization is.
Right.
The Industry 4.0 talk that we've all been in for years has actually, you know, there's been some bad fallout on this because there hasn't been specialization just in data and data management and things like that. And there's been a lot of people burned because, let's say, they tried to go to a pick and place company that is selling, you know, their MES type solution that works great for their systems, but then they can't necessarily do something with, you know, AOI company X or screen printer company Y. And, you know, there's been a lot of false starts that have initiated with that. And I think truly you need a software provider that provides a platform designed specifically for this type of enterprise solution that Arch is talking about.
Right. Yeah, I think where you're coming from is really that the Arch, at the end of the day, is a large data cruncher. You're able to handle really large data sets where other people are not, you know, in that area.
It's actually much harder than most people think.
I bet.
Because it's not just collecting the data, you know, very rapidly, but it's also manipulating that data in such a format that it's able to be contextualized on some level at that part, but also brought up into the cloud very, very efficiently.
Yeah.
Okay, and kept in its native format. So you get all the context and nuance that's in there, and being able to jump across those data points in multiple parts of the process across multiple products in near
multiple
real time.
Multiple sites.
Yeah, multiple sites worldwide near real time. It's not just something that anybody can do. There's a lot of intellectual, you know, capital that went into Arch on how we're able to do this, and it's part of what makes us unique in the industry.
Great. Well, we look forward to hearing more as it develops, Dave, and I want to thank you for telling us about it and coming in today.
Thanks a lot, Trevor.
Okay, thank you.
Ko Young is leading a smart revolution that will change the world of electronics manufacturing. Based on our pioneering True 3D measurement-based inspection technology, we revolutionized the solder paste inspection market to such great lengths that 1 in 2 SPIs sold today is from Ko Young. Building our SPI technology, we expanded to automated optical inspection, also known as AOI. Every year, we introduce new award-winning innovations and have proudly earned the respect from thousands of customers across diverse industries. Aside from our R&D center in Korea, we have research facilities focused on artificial intelligence and deep learning across the world to help us further develop proprietary AI technologies for your challenges. With our global network of sales and service centers, we aim to respond quickly to your needs and to deliver the highest level of customer satisfaction.